Okay. Let's get back to it then. Heal, good, good. Okay.
Submit to a credit check, or present your passport before proceeding to the gate. Trespassers will be shot. Please submit to a credit check, or present a passport.
Yep, tried. Actually, wait.
Please.
Let's, because didn't I have two science magazines? I think I had two on me. Weapon... Oh well then.
Submit to a credit check. Thank you, madam. You may proceed.
Now I hope that's a one-time payment.
Move along.
That'll be a one-time payment. Because that'll be bullshit if I have to pay $2,000 every time to come in here.
Strip secure.
Gonna have words with your commanding officer after this.
Yeah, a few too many drunks. Speaking of drunks, actually, though, I need to find that one guy. Let's see. We'll do that one later. Yeah. Let's see where that is. Recording this, not that very far.
Howdy, partner! You've come for a piece, haven't you? Welcome to New Vegas. Consider me your personal welcome wagon. Now hear this. The head honcho of New Vegas, Mr. House, is itching to make your acquaintance. Just head for the Lucky 38. It's the big old tower shaped like a roulette spinner. It was Mr. House that made secure trons like me. Seems the least I can do is pass on his message. Don't dawdle. He'll be waiting.
And its face just turned into a secure tron.
No loitering.
Wait, what? That was just... Wait, Okay. Why are you clapping?
Huh. So the Garrett sent you to track me down. What a joke. I'd rather not waste the ammo, kid. But if you insist, draw. Aha!
So they didn't have a problem with that. Oh, true you. You can turn that in, so... It wants me to go in that room. And then cops is over there, which is where Benny is supposedly. This is, I don't know how to pronounce that, the Goimina? Goimina? Yeah. Well, I guess let's go ahead and head over here. I guess we'll check this out. I'll probably want to save. Could have some ramificationable choices here, possibly.
Well, howdy, partner. Good to see you again. Boss is waiting for you upstairs, so get a move on. I see you brought some friends. Sorry, partner, but they're gonna have to stay outside. Boss is pretty clear on this. I can't let you in unless you buy your lonesome. Well, howdy, partner. Good to...
So I take it though in wait mode then. So if Mr. House is here, why would he be like literally at the entrance of the strip? Isn't that kind of a fucking stupid place to put yourself? Interesting. It's not wobbly. Why it's so freaking dark here. Kinda eerie in here. Wait. Plus, you would think they would have this fucking place cleaned out by now. I guess I gotta go in that.
Where to, partner? Bed house floor.
Well, hello, sugar. Mr. House is waiting for you in his office.
I'm Jane, one of Mr. House's girls. We keep him entertained. We don't get many guests lately. Perhaps we can entertain you as well. Oh, there's lots of things to tell, I'm sure. There's the three families, the casinos, the other attractions. What would you like to know? They're just new money, sugar. They might pretend they're sophisticated, but between you and me, they're not far off from tribals. Their marriages especially are just awful brutes. The chairman and the White Glove Society at least pretend to have some culture. Well, of course, there used to be a lot more of them. But these days, there are three open to the public. The Tops, the Ultra Lukes, and Gamora. And the Lucky 38, of course. But we're not open to the public. You're a special case, sugar. Well, let's see. The NCR has an embassy here. But why you'd want to go talk to a bunch of boring old politicians, I surely don't know. Oh, And the Vault 21 Hotel and Gift Shop has an adorable collection of old Vault Tech memorabilia. And I suppose if you like neon signs, you might check out Michelangelo's sign shop. Anything you like, sugar? Why, sugar? He's the maximum utmost. If it weren't for Mr. House, we wouldn't have this fabulous wonderland of New Vegas, would we? Well, of course I am, silly. Mr. House is just the smartest, most wonderful man there ever was. Why, did you know he single-handedly reclaimed New Vegas from all those nasty tribes that used to live here? Well, he single-handedly sent in his Securitrons to do it, but that counts in my book. Sugar, I may be a robot on the outside, but on the inside, my neurocomputational matrix is an exact copy of Mr. House's favorite girl. Mr. House has a lot of needs, sugar. I take care of all of them, and a lady doesn't kiss and tell. Then maybe you shouldn't pry into a lady's particulars, Anything? This is the Lucky 38 Resort and Casino, or it used to be. Mr. House has kept the place locked up tight for ages now. Nobody comes in or out. Why, I'm a Robco PDQ-88B Mark I Securitron, you silly goose. We're the finest in personal civil robotic security on the market. Not many people know this, but Mr. House is one of the world's biggest collectors of antique snow globes. If you happen to find any out in the wasteland, you can bring them to me, and I'll add them to his collection. You'll get a reward, of course. In fact, one of Mr. House's favorites went missing when we moved the collection. If you have a look around the Lucky 38, you might even find it.
Snow globes, huh? So people don't go in or out of this place, huh? Most
sweet. Have a nice day.
Hey, I'm not doing anything. Well, lets me sleep in it. Can't complain about that. Mr. House. Now, this is... I said that there was something I did know about Mr. House, and this is what it was. That, well, he's apparently a computer screen. The reason for that is because there were bazillions and bazillions of thumbnails that use him, so... If you ever browse anything Fallout on fucking YouTube, you will probably find it very hard to never see one. I guess it's downstairs we go then. So it looks like, yeah, we went up from the looks of it, so. Except for this shoddy looking spawn here. Lots of empty crap. That's a lot of books. You think books in such good condition like that would be worth something more? Octonal.
Be advised. Visitors will be held responsible for the behavior of any robots accompanying them.
Hmm. I don't see a globe anywhere. Okay then. Let's talk, Mr. House.
This meeting has been a long time coming, hasn't it? You've come a long ways. Literally, and I suspect, figuratively as well. I have to ask, now that you've reached your destination, what do you make of what you see? Of course you haven't. Vegas always was one of a kind. What you see down on the strip is just a fraction of the city's former glory, and yet, more than an echo, I preserved its spirit. Or perhaps you were referring to the Lucky 38? The years haven't been kind to her, but still she manages to impress. Oh, don't be coy. You've been playing a high-stakes game ever since Victor dug you out of the ground. Don't be afraid to admit it. The business is this. One of my employees has stolen an item of extraordinary value from me, and I want it recovered. Simple enough. What did you wish to know? My only concern is the recovery of the platinum chip. What happens to Benny, I leave to your discretion. When you bring the chip to me, I will pay you 4 times the delivery bonus stipulated in your contract. How's that? My offer far exceeds the original terms of your contract, which, I will remind you, already obligates you to deliver the chip. You have an interest in this, whether you like it or not. You signed a contract to deliver the platinum chip to me. Now, I could stop you from leaving, but what would that accomplish? If you want to go, go. See what the strip I built, the strip I own, has to offer. Think about what I could offer you. I expect we'll have occasion to talk again. Have you considered the terms of my offer? There's little else for us to discuss until you have. It won't be easy. Benny is always surrounded by at least 4 bodyguards, except when he's in his private suite on the 13th floor of the Tops. It's more complicated than that. The chairmen share what you might call a tribal affinity. Look for a man named Swank, Benny's second in command. He's always been a reliable, if unimaginative, employee. Do your best to convince him that you're working under my auspices. If you have evidence of Benny's crimes, show it to him. By contract, Securitrons are to enter the casinos only when invited by the 3 families, or if other extraordinary circumstances arise. The moment I send one into the Tops, Benny will know I'm on to him. If you were to approach Benny in public, you might be able to leverage his fear of exposure to make him agree to meet with you in private. Sneaking into Benny's suite on the 13th floor would be very difficult, but not impossible. There might be guards. Certainly there'd be a sturdy lock on his front door. Benny has led the chairman ever since I recruited his tribe 7 years ago. Until his recent misbehavior, I'd planned to make him my protege. Maybe if I'd begun grooming him sooner, none of this would have happened. To achieve my aims, I require a capable human agent to perform certain tasks. I knew Benny was ambitious, even ruthless. But I believed he would do the job so long as he was incentivized appropriately. Obviously, I miscalculated his drive for supremacy. But in any case, you've come along. A more than suitable replacement. I have to think that he found out about the platinum chip and mistakenly convinced himself that he could use it to his own ends. One of the problems of a tribal workforce, I'm afraid. No intuitive understanding of how complex technologies can be. Why didn't Victor intervene sooner, you mean? Good Springs is a bit too far away for me to reliably control a Securitron agent by remote. I can send and receive packets of data at best. Victor's combat algorithms determined the proper course of action. Benny and his thugs were more than a match for a lone Securitron. When he alerted me, I instructed him to approach the site after Benny and the others had departed. What else did you want to know? It's a very special item. There's nothing else like it in the entire world. It was lost a long time and difficult to find. That's all you need to know about it for this stage of our enterprise. Fulfill your contract, deliver the chip, and good things will come your way. You realize you were just one of many couriers. The rest of them, dummies, so to speak. Add to that many thousands of caps worth of mercenary protection to screen your avenue of approach. Had I used an armed caravan to transport the chip, I might as well have been announcing to the world, "This is important! Attack this!" I didn't want to attract the attention of groups like the Great Khans or the Brotherhood of Steel. Alas, the real threat was closer to home. Frontal assaults on casinos? Not good for business. In any case, Benny would see it coming, and all he'd have to do is hold the chip up and point a pistol at it. Our foremost advantage is that Benny doesn't know that I know he has the chip. Let's not squander it. You might keep an eye out for any computers that Benny's been using. Maybe even a computer lab of some sort. That's simply not true. I am the only person to hold any rights pertaining to the chip. I designed it, and I paid for it dearly. To develop that chip, I spent a sum of US dollars. Not the bottle caps that pass as currency these days, but a sum beyond counting. For decades, I paid salvagers to comb the ruins for it. And when it was finally discovered, tens of thousands of caps spent to have it brought here. We know how that turned out. Complete your contract, and it will be the last time I pay for the chip. Save your questions for then. I am Robert Edwin House, president, CEO, and sole proprietor of the New Vegas Strip. I oversaw the city's renovations starting from 2274 onward. The three families are my employees. Before the Great War of 2077, I was the founder, president, and CEO of Robco Industries, a vast computer and robotics corporation.
So that would explain why he's a computer.
Don't let the video screens and computer terminals fool you. I'm flesh and blood, not silicon. I see you've made a study of the topic. My knowledge of the science of longevity would fill several textbooks. Perhaps after a decade or two of economic reconstruction, I can commercialize these technologies and offer them to others, such as yourself. Let's just say it was very costly. But I was willing to make the sacrifices longevity entailed, financial and otherwise. We can discuss this in greater detail at another time. Suffice it to say that when my Securitrons detected NCR scouts at Hoover Dam, I took action. I recruited a tribal force to supplement my Securitrons and renovated the strip just in time to welcome the NCR as it marched into the region. Instead of war, a treaty was negotiated, and the money started to pour in. It's understandable that you'd be curious about this topic, but we'll hold off until the platinum chip has been recovered. What else did you want to know? Have you considered the terms of my offer? There's little else for us. You signed a contract in good faith to deliver that chip. You're going to have a hard time on the strip if you are so incautious of making enemies.
I need some more evidence you're not evil, Mr. House. Interesting, you got cameras everywhere. But I will see myself out, so. But I can see I'm in a situation where you can't necessarily just kill me either. You need a pawn. Regardless of whether you like it or not. So, hey. Good luck convincing me of any good, then.
Congratulations, partner. The boss has instructed me to comp you to the High Roller Suite. You can bring your friends, too. Be like a little clubhouse for the gang you put together. Just bear in mind, you're the only one gets to see the boss. Any friends you got, they can wait in the suite. Enjoy the digs, partner. They're plenty fancy.
Casino. So, can I go and get all the people I found so far, then?
High Roller Suite.
Lighting is so dark inside. Pretty decent sized place.
Where to, partner?
Slot machines can't use. Here we go. People next. penthouse was where he is. Now we'll see if they're still down there at the entrance. Can I actually play any of the casino stuff down here?
Be advised, visitors will be held responsible for the behavior of any non-human sapiens accompanying them.
So it looks like there's no gambling in here. Yeah, good, they're still here.
Hey, you there. I have a message for you. It's from Ambassador Crocker. Very important. Here you go.
Who the hell is Bastel?
Patrolling the Mojave almost make you wish for a nuclear winter.
All right, dearie, let's go.
Oh, I see. Long command. Okay. So let's see what this fucking level is. So desperate to talk to me, he's willing to pardon anything I've done.
My, but that Lucky 38 is a large building. And so fancy. Oh, Pumpkin. Grandma's sorry about that. Sometimes she gets mad and listens to Leo, which you really shouldn't. The medicine is supposed to help with that. But sometimes Grandma doesn't take it. Sometimes it makes Grandma forget things she doesn't want to forget, Pumpkin.
Almost out of caps.
Yeah, they just said I walked out. I could have seen what's in. Yeah, I guess he did say nobody goes in and out, so I guess that is kind of weird to them. Well, we're in a whole new area. There's places to check out, so let's just start looking around. Find shit to do. We gotta get ideas to get to Benny, so. And I would like to learn more about Mr. House and what he attends.
Hey, no one but Omertas are allowed to carry guns into Gamora. Check your weapons with me. You'll get these back on your way out.
I bell.
Hello and welcome to Gamora. I sure do, but loose lips sink ships. All right, you look pretty trustworthy. I've heard some pretty shady rumors about the Ultralux. I'm not sure what the deal is, but although they try to put on airs, that place is just plain creepy. Maybe it's the masks. Gossip is one thing, dirt on the family is something else totally.
It looks like we can use this to do the same stuff and play blackjack and that. I imagine we can also get banned here or something, probably. Wait, when cash? What's your boss? File, blackjack, roulette. Hate roulette. Ugh. Let's take a look around now. Yeah, something tells me I probably should turn around, but... Oh shit.
Glad. I'm gonna make mincemeat out of
you. Oh fuck. I did not mean to do that. Fucking hell. The shitty thing is I didn't even actually lockpick it, I immediately canceled. But fucking hell. Okay, I'm careful on some of the doors.
Bosses don't like no trouble in there. Find yourself a girl or a guy. Have some fun.
Yeah, this is just a strip area.
I got kicked out of Ultralux the other day. Man, that place gives me the fucking freaks.
What's the problem?
Gamora has the loosest slots on the strip.
I hope my dad doesn't find out how much money his hookers cost.
So I hope my dad don't know I've been using on escorts, man. That takes me to a stairwell, probably. So, don't look like anything interest on this floor. Check up the other one, and I'll do gambling off screen. Something simple to do off screen. Oh, I guess that was downstairs. Nice. Room locked. Bathroom.
There's some serious shit going on between NCR and the Legion. Better not fuck with our power.
Private room.
Hey there! Can I get... Sorry, it's not my business to get involved. Hey.
Worthless.
I got kicked out of Ultralux the other day. Man, that place gives me the fucking freaks.
Oh, it is that side. Yeah. Don't look like there's really anything in here. Oh, wait. My guns, though. Or is it still Paw Heel?
Well, what do we have here, huh? Let me guess. You've heard about the mistress who makes all your fantasies come true.
No.
So you followed the call of your desires, all the way to the arms of Joanna. Moi. Now that you've found me, I wonder, do you have what it takes?
No, I haven't held literally anything.
Oh, confident. I like that. So, what do you want to do with what you've got?
Really close.
All right, honey. Yes.
See.
Oh, nothing special, hon. I'm the best lay in Gamora, and that's all you need to know. I like that you're here. Doesn't that make you happy? I'm not, but questions bore me, hon. I'm not.
Eh. Come on, it was 72 out of 75. The percentage of failure had to be pretty low. It still failed anyway. Don't look like anyone particular interest, just a bunch of dumb heads all everywhere. Gamble. She banished her now. I mean, even a few points off must still be a pretty strong chance of loss, so I just really have a shitty odds. Aside from that other floor. Let's go to the suits. See what's up there. I was hoping somebody would have some dirt or something, but not seeing anything too particular. So it's interesting, you know, he really wants this chip, but he's actually afraid of using his robots to do anything, though. Well, it's a little messy up here.
Hey, nice to meet you. Do you need help with something? A little bit of this and a little bit of that. I'm a close friend of some of the family around here. I do some independent contracting around the casino, and they set me up with this great room.
He's probably full of quest. Theft up here, so. And they really like getting stuck on things.
Howdy. Fiends are bad for business. NCR should do their fucking job.
Find yourself a girl or a guy. Have some fun.
No way that way. Yeah, so it looks like this place is just, meh. At least until we get something that sends us here. Now.
Holy shit, you been in Lucky 38? You meet the big man in there? I think there is something wrong with that dog.
Now you're wearing a hat. Easy. And, I mean, not easy, but he doesn't count as waking in. Yeah, everything in here is stuff to steal, though. Oh, well. Free XP is free XP, eh?
Business is good. All the family's got money. Of course, Gamora is where the action is.
Damn, fucking 100?
Hey!
Oh no! Fucking! Damn it. Thought that was the fucking elevator. Fucking hell. Just go pick the lock real quick and get out of here then. Damn it.
Be sure to check out the courtyard. Some of the hottest asses in New Vegas shaking out there.
Yeah, whatever, buddy. So what is that one labeled? An express elevator to the lower levels. So there's another level underneath the lower level? That's a Resident Evil 2 hideouts going on here. Well, this place turned out to be a bore. I mean, I don't know about back in the day, but yeah, if you're looking for hot women or guys or anything, Google's your better friend than this place, so. I seriously just wait for them all to be added individually. A fucking annoying system. And let me guess. Yes, everything's removed! Again! Everyone loves wasting all their fucking time. Let's take a look at the next area then. And I guess I should go see about getting all my companions up. Okay, so I can get there from over here too. That's good. So that's Big Tops, I'm assuming. Yeah. So we gotta find a way through there.
Later, whoever you are.
And that's the place those people were saying was creepy. And this is the Lava B LVB station. Little station. Well, NCO guy just went in there, so this might be the embassy then that he talked about. Go ahead and see in here then. I wonder if the NCR knows something about. Well, actually, I bet I know why. Because they saw me go in, and then they saw me come out, and then they're like, holy fuck! A human being went in.
What's a mutant doing in the strip?
Hey. Racism less, please.
Howdy, young lady. How can I help you? But make it quick. Goddamn heat's worse in this town than in the middle of a Brahmin herd at noon. Sharp eyes on you, all right. We've gone through a heap of trouble to get in town. Ethel says I just need to wet my throat. A drink? Nonsense. All I need now is to settle a score. We didn't come a long ways just to stroll our best clothes around. There's a long list of grievances that Heck Gunderson's got to answer for, kid. I'm here to make sure that rancher stops stealing our lands. If he ain't chiseling behind your back, he just sends his men ready for a fight. Then you either sell your ranch for a penny, or you're dead. I'm tired of being trampled over, kid, and I got a good mind to stop Heck once and for all. We are honest folk out there. Damn hard to make a living in the desert, kid. Heck's a different breed. Goddamn thief he is. Scaring us into giving away our lands is all he's done to strike it flush. Comes packing iron and none can hold a candle to his men. Bad blood. I have no illusions that he'll ever stop his plundering, so I'm just gonna make him suffer. That's what I'm gonna do. Here in town, he's got a few of his armed men to protect him. I just gotta find out what he's up to, and then I'll know where to hit him hard. Where I come from, we appreciate good intentions. I reckon you could help me figure out what he's doing in town. Tell you what, that chiseler's blowing hot air over at that there fancy casino, the Ultra Lux. Find out what's his story here, will you? All right, kid. I appreciate it. I hope to see you soon.
If you don't mind, I have to look after my husband.
I bet it feels real nice to be carrying those weapons around on the strip. That damn Mr. House has forbid any NCR military personnel from carrying any sort of firearms on the strip. Well, except for Captain Pappas. Mr. House still doesn't trust the NCR. A word of advice. The Securitrons won't put up with any funny stuff out there, so don't do anything stupid. This your first time on the strip? Well, it's time to pop your Vegas cherry, friend. I'm sure you'll have a blast and be drunk and capless in no time. I can give you a bit more information about the various casinos if you're not sure on where to get started. Well, there's Vault 21 and the NCR Embassy. Both places are located on the south side of the strip. Vault 21 is a small hotel and gift shop. It's not as nice as the casinos, but it's a whole hell of a lot cheaper.
The NCR embassy is the headquarters for the NCR on the Strip. The ambassador and his offices are there, as well as the MP headquarters.
Ma'am?
You think these people would clean up some of these buildings, you know?
Enjoy your time in Vegas.
Can't gamble, heal.
Watch out!
Oh, what?
Watch out!
What? Come on. What the? What the fuck was up with that bullshit? Fuck. I didn't even interact with something. I literally was just walking. That's delightful.
Howdy, young lady.
Bet it feels real.
So they're like saying by the door without guns. Like, did somebody... Okay, maybe I misunderstood the situation. Let me pay closer attention here. Maybe somebody with a gun came in and...
What's a mutant doing in the Strip?
Hold it. NCR only beyond this point. Keep your distance.
Oh, okay. That would be why then. Okay. Well, violent, but whatever. Go fuck off then. Assholes. Sheesh. I don't know what the fuck their problem is. Sheesh. Well, Holt's over there.
Morning.
Why don't I start looking into that? Yeah, let's start looking into this. So let's strip one by one. I mean, I get the logistics of them wanting to take your guns away, like at the other one. I hope they don't do it at this one, but that is... annoying that it doesn't remember what slots and shit it's equipped to. That is stupid.
You should have just not had that function or
disable the ability to pull out your guns or something.
Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapons?
Oh, that is creepy looking. Keep holdout weapons.
My deepest apologies for the slightest inconvenience. You have my assurance that everything will be returned upon your departure. But we simply can't have anyone waving their weapons around in the hotel. It's not the atmosphere we wish to cultivate. Please, enjoy your stay. They'll be handled with the utmost security in our bank.
It is just most creepy looking. He got the, like, veins on his hands too.
Morning.
You watch yourself around Mr. Gunderson.
Beg your pardon, stranger, but I'm looking for someone. You ain't seen a young man with dark brown hair and a white hat on lately, have you?
Hmm.
Ain't nobody got one darn piece of news about my boy. Ain't got one Brahmin unaccounted for across a dozen ranches. But I'm here for an hour and my own son just up and disappears on me. Yep, got a whole mess of Brahmins to my name. Bighorners, too. Used to just have the one ranch, but land was easy to grab before the soldiers moved in. Before I knew it, I was running one of the biggest ranching operations east of California. Now, everywhere I go, folks I never even met shake my hand and call me Mr. Gunderson. Don't quite know what to make of that. Made me a special arrangement with the hotel. They want to do business with me, they got to play by my rules. A lot of people out there resent success, might want to take a swipe at me. This makes them think twice. If I'd have been thinking, though, I'd have had him watching my boy instead. Then none of this would have happened. My boy, Ted, he was right here. I didn't leave him but a minute. I told him to stay put while I talked some things over with the White Glove folks. He was never one to stay tied down to a spot, though. Gets that from his mother. Got most of my staff out looking for him now. I'd be out myself, but I keep hoping he'll show up back here. Of course, if he does that, I'll whoop him till his skinny hide turns to leather for putting me through this. But that don't mean I wouldn't be grateful. That's between me and the White Glove Society. But let's just say they control the food supply around here, and I got lots of food to give. But that ain't as welcome as you might think. That's what they call themselves, the folk that run this place. They're the ones dressed all fancy with their bow ties and shiny dresses. Some of them got masks, too. Real hard to trust folks like that. A couple of them show their faces, and that's who I do my business with. I don't talk to none of the other ones. I'd be more than happy to have you. Heck, I'll hire anybody with a pair of legs and at least one good eye at this point. There'd be a lot of money in it for you if you can get him back to me safe. And if he ain't, you can bet I'll pay for the names of the sons of bitches responsible.
So he's looking for his son. I could do a bit of a duo thing, look for a son and then feed the information about what he's doing here to them, but let's see what they have to say about the situation. They might even know something about his son too. Yeah, I'm just not going to worry about equipping my guns at the moment if it's just going to keep going back and forth. Yeah, that's fine. Like, where were they again? So, hopefully... Let's see if it just keeps going. Hopefully it does. Because that would be annoying if you have to also wait for them to add each thing. Yeah, so it keeps adding.
Howdy. Good seeing you again.
What the... Boy, I did that. I did want to save before it continued in case something bad happens. After all, I want to be cautious. Something bad could happen after all.
Howdy. Good seeing. I hear. Sure, kid. And I still hump like a buck in spring. That Gunderson's a liar and born of a viper, I swear. I got some. Okay. Darn far it is, our ranch. Ethel would be happy to yap about that. I got more important things in mind, kid. Bighorn is my trade since I was a young'un. I confess, it's hard living these days, kid. The wasteland ain't the same anymore. Darn far. Bighorn is my trade. I know it better than my wife's corset. What about it, kid? Stealing our purebred resolve, that's how. We faced the wasteland right in the old mug and told her to shove it. Listen, we own these lands. And I'll be damned if the NCR, those Legion bastards, or anyone else tries to walk all over us. Hell, it's all dangerous. Know why? Because you can't trust anything that stands on two legs. If you're looking for real trouble, head straight into the mountains. Men don't walk up there, for good reasons, kid. Howdy.
So I'm in a situation where I don't know who's necessarily be good.
Oh, be damned. You mean the young Gunderson? That's a shaved tail if I ever saw one. He's got less sense than a Brahmin at a crossroads. I'd not be one to complain if you got lost for good, kid. If it makes Hex suffer, then I'm all for it. So Ted's nowhere to be found, and Hex quite unprotected while looking for him, huh? Hell, it sounds like the perfect time to get even. Heck won't know what hit him. What do you say? A ransom? I doubt that snake's got enough soul to care that much for his own young'un. Besides, what's to stop him after his son's returned? Nah, Heck only knows greed and pain, kid. It's high time he got paid back in kind. His life or his son's. Either way, I win.
I hear the fucking hold people. Hostages.
I won't hold it against you, kid. You gotta do your clean thing. I respect that. Oh.
If you don't mind, I have. He's got his reasons. And when that man gets a notion stuck in his head, he's like a bighorn or bull that's seen red. And if it means Heck Gunderson's involved, then you better step aside before the stampede tramples you over. If that's what you want to talk about, go. Everything he says about the evils of Heck Gunderson is true. But I've never held the notion that fighting evil with evil carries the world forward. I don't suppose you have the magic powers necessary to bring my husband to his senses, do you? He swears he won't leave this godforsaken city until he's seen Heck suffer. So far as I can see, we're the only ones in pain. That's very kind of you. Maybe this will be the dawn of a new day.
Yeah, see, I can understand, like, even if what he's saying is true, but I don't feel like mortal or holding a, like, the kid, I imagine, isn't responsible for his parents, so I mean, that's just dragging other people in. So I don't feel like that's the appropriate way to handle it. If they were to pull out violence, that'd be a different thing.
Howdy. Good seeing you. Kid, look around you. There's poison and death everywhere. And people like Heck are responsible for the misery we suffer. What right do they have to continue with their mischief and killing, huh? Same. The right of might, kid. The Gundersons will pay.
Damn, I cannot succeed at any fucking speech unless I'm maxed or over the requirement. I just can't win any of the lower ones. What is 1 point off of the speech? Like, what's the percentage odds? Because if I was to assume 75 be 100% and each percent be a little bit, I would think 72 is a pretty good odds, I would think.
Same.
I mean, like, what the fuck, man? This is like Final Fantasy Tactics odds, for fuck's sake. It has to be something really different, like... maybe one represents 75% off and so on, so maybe the odds are more like 3% or something.
Same. The right of might, kid.
When am I to a level? How about I put you on hold for now, so I can get my speech higher. Because I would like to resolve your problem more better. And I'd rather not... because that other guy doesn't at least appear to be awful, and I can feel bad for his son, and perhaps rescuing his son can lead to something good. Because I could use his son's rescue as leverage to request him to not be doing whatever he's doing to him, perhaps. Gotta resolve this a little more peacefully. Don't need one and gun and watch everyone blow up into little pieces. Okay, then. So, yeah. Well, you know, I still never even went back to the caravan company either, actually. It's supposed to be somewhere, though. I really hope I don't have to... I would imagine the 2,000 was a one-time payment, because, I mean, if it does ask you to pay every time, I would imagine I can use the warp system to get around it now. You know, actually, why would the robot request 2,000 chips? Wouldn't, since House wanted to talk to me, why wouldn't he just let me in? Okay, yeah, well, on this side. So let's see what happens if I walk up. Does he...
move along.
Okay, so it's a one-time payment. Good. I can go with that. Why did you run all the way that way? Oh, yeah, my shit's decrypted. I'm not gonna enjoy this part. Sure, some unlucky bastard wants to die. Now, I can't really imagine getting this far. Like, you know, there was the escorts that protect you. I can't imagine getting this far and not being able to fight the random people that attack you here. Yeah, I thought you were supposed to have a partner. I don't see a partner. She lied.
Welcome to the Silver Rush. New Vegas' best. I'm just kidding. Go on in.
You don't want to recognize me, huh? Alright, well, let's turn in the request for this. Well, made it worth my time, because, I mean, costed me 2,000 caps to fucking even get in the first place.
People are talking, buddy. You've made quite an impression on the strip.
Some gamblers came in saying they'd seen you enter the Lucky 38. I have to say, I'm impressed. I don't know of any other living person who's been in there. Yes! Where's his hat? This is great news. No one screws with the Garrett twins and gets away with it. I need to find a place on the wall for this. And for your reward, here's 150 caps. I trust there were also some valuables on McCaffrey. Also, we would like to set you up with a room. You can have the corner room, rent-free. It was McCaffrey's. Now that he's dead, we're happy to let you use it. Thanks for helping us.
Ooh, nice. 660.
Later.
What's up, Rex?
So he said, is it this room? No? Found a level 4. At least I thought she said a level 4.
You better get out of here if you know what's good for you.
Yeah. Violent.
Move along, please.
Yeah, you think they would let me play more gambling as a reward? Oh, there has to be a womb up here then. Goes there. Kind of a pointless area there. Oh, okay, so this would be the womb then. All stealing the store and anything of that. But at least I could sleep, so can't complain much about that. $150 caps though, that's pretty new. Damn, in hardcore, you gotta have a doctor's bag or actually have a doctor will fix your limbs. Shit. That must be a fucking nightmare.
Yep.
Let's see, they're all hanging out here too. Come on, you two. Let's see. We can go deliver a package too. Like, how close are we to a level now? We got like over 600 EXP for that torment. So we should be pretty close, I imagine. So I have to be careful about more Legion assassins. Like, sheesh. What if there's like a time on how often they do that? Be nice to know. Oh yes, I'm much closer now. Let's see, so... The house always wins. One. What's that? 20... And those little, I believe all those are the DLC, right? That should be only, wasn't that just four? Four DLCs, right? Yeah, there were four DLCs, so before. Below Wing-a-Ding-Dings. Okay, now that was the sheriff, so then, yeah, these four are the DLC. So, we look into the delivery request then. Because about around 1:30, I'm gonna leave early, because... Again, a friend of mine is doing an event in VOC, so I'm gonna go attend that. That might become normal on Saturdays, possibly. Because they seem to do... Because this is a different group. Few of my friends from the walkout group I do are part of it. That's how I got to be a part of it. But, yeah, I think they do this usually on Saturdays, so... Anyway, so what is... Looked at it, so let's see, where the hell was it? Out there. Let's go to the gun one of those, because it's obviously outside. Yeah, it might be a good opportunity to pick up some ammo. Because that's probably the other problem. I'm using a lot of the basic ammo. I need, like, armor-piercing fucking shit for those guys in the fucking Roman armor. Next level is going to be a pork too, which is good, good, good. Wondering if I want to invest into another, like, get more EXP faster kind of thing, maybe. Because the level is up to 50, and we're at, well, like, 15 now, so.
Welcome, sir or madam.
Piercing. Those. now I got some random stones. Thank you. Good day to you. Hello. So AP should be armor piercing. I hear something buzzing. Oh, yeah. Chainsaw. And a big dump. Alright, well, let's hope we don't get any trouble, but I feel like this is gonna be a setup. Not necessarily one that they're purposely sending me to, but I'm pretty sure the people I'm meeting are not gonna be. Let's go in the house. Let's just put it. Pointless bridge. What's this down here? I don't get why it's... Let's go. Guess I'm supposed to go in the house first. I mean, it shows Dot specifically going to it. When I look out in the direction of the arrow, it doesn't show it. But you see, it shows it there, so I guess it's part of it. This sweaty. I can tell it seems like it wants me to enter this house, so. Door to Isaac's house. Not blinking on this one. This is particularly weird. What about the back door then? Let's save then. I am particularly confused why it seems it wants to go in the house. Oh, okay, that works. Appears to be in here. Guess we'll just go to the spot then. I mean, it's not a weird thing getting from the. Oh, now it's. Now it shows it for though. Why did it want us to go in the house for though? It's kind of confusing actually. Shotgun loop. Since we gotta go in close, makes sense and he's the only one here. No wheel armor, so if you cross me, fucker, your head's going poof.
Are you the Van Graaff's emissary? Do you have what we requested? We were told there would be no questions. Do you have what we requested or not? Huh. Then our business is concluded. Tell your superiors that we will contact them shortly. We've already concluded our business. I suggest you return to your employers.
I hope I don't get graded on that. Like, she's like, you asked questions! I did save when I came out of the house, right? Yeah. So I should be able to do that. Was she? Let's see what she says. I was expecting, like, a way the people to be like, look out, you're dead! See, I wish you could choose which side to be on. That would be just a teensy bit helpful. Country world, some of these sins.
reign supreme.
Hey, you're the one who's been going around helping people around here, right? The king says to keep up the good work. He said to give you this.
Yeah, thanks. I feel honored. Thanks. Okay, anyway. This way? Big boys goo. I mean, maybe now he'll actually do my request about wanting to be a king, actually, because people are liking me more and more, so maybe he'll actually let me be a king. It's time to get revenge for all those ran over Elvis impersonators in Grand Theft Auto, yeah?
Wanna get lucky? Head on down to the Atomic Ring.
Lady, I am a lady in this game. And I'm traveling with a female super mutant grandma. Get lost. Who talks about whores with their grandma present? Sheesh. Anyway.
Hello?
Oh, what? No more questions about my weapons? Well, I'm cool with that. I mean, I guess technically I'm an employee right now, so I guess it would make sense to not take my weapons.
Welcome back. Did you have news for me, or are you just here for the guns? And don't leave me in suspense. What was their reaction? Good. Good. Here's your payment. If you'll excuse me, I have some thinking to do. Oh, Jean-Baptiste was talking about a matter earlier that he needs help with. I volunteered you. See him for the details.
Ah, just the person I was looking for. Your name came up in a discussion we had recently. My sister is very impressed with you so far, but I'm not. I don't think you have what it takes to work for this family. Luckily for you, I'm going to give you a chance to prove me wrong. What do you say? Want to make some real money? All right then. If we're going to work together, there's only one thing you need to know about me. I like things simple. Recently, Glory negotiated a deal between us and a big-time player. We're talking more caps than you'd probably see in a lifetime. Your part in this is simple. To finalize this deal, I need to tie up a loose end. To do that, there's a girl I need you to find. Her name is Rose of Sharon Cassidy. That's some fancy shit, right? Don't know what her mother was thinking with a name like that. But this girl and I, we need to have a discussion. Find her. Bring her here so I can talk to her one-on-one. If your answer isn't yes, I'll bring her here, or no, I won't because Gloria had me pegged wrong, then we're done here. Really, NCR all around her. Well, tell you what, you find a way to bring her here. She'll want to hear what I have to say. I got business here. Need to watch the shop, make sure things are running smoothly. Besides, if I came for the girl, I'm not all friendly and charming like you are. She might get the wrong idea. Find her, bring her back here so we can talk. Needless to say, there's some good money in it for you.
I need to know a little bit more. You sound more like you have ill intentions, which is a little concerning to me. Really concerning, honestly. Oh. Okay. Wow. All the way back over there? Holy crap. Thank goodness for fast travel. See, more when you didn't have fast travel in that game, you actually had to travel on foot. Or magic. The only other option was these, like, big creatures. I don't even remember what they looked like anymore. But I think there was, like, three of them located on the whole map in cities that you could use to generally get to someone's sides of the map. But other than that, you had to fucking do it by freaking walking. Patrol in the stream chat really makes me wish for a nuclear winnow. Cool, yo. Welcome back. Right now I'm trying to get a level up so I can get enough speech to convince a guy to put his hate behind him. Usually there's a merchant near you. I don't see one. Seems to have gone separated from them. Oh well. So who am I looking for again? Cassidy. Sean Cassidy. Let's see. I'm blanking now. What was the name of the sniper? Looks like it's going in that direction. Nope. That was Ghost. He's blinking down here, though. So, go inside this building, apparently.
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count on that.
So I'm assuming it means her then. Well, well, well. Funny thing how things come all back around, eh? Come on, I wanna save. Hut, 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 hey, watch where you go. Punk. So say foul currently. 5,000 on the dot.
You come around like a bad habit. What's on your mind?
It's been like weeks now.
Jean Baptiste. Sounds like someone got knocked out of the good book so hard his name broke. Either that or it's Canadarian or some such shit. So who is this Baptiste, and what does he want? The only Van Graffs I know are the ones out west. Well, except for Gloria Van Graff, and I don't know her all that well. Nor do I want to. Don't have any objection speaking with him. Though if he's with the Van Graffs, he should know I'm not looking to buy weapons.
So,
you come around like a bad habit. Not leaving here until my caravan papers clear. Or my title goes away. If you were looking for someone to caravan with, I'd try the Crimson Caravan up north. They pretty much run the roads now.
So then I need to get... So I gotta do the caravan thing then. So So ironically, I gotta go do that. Well, I was hoping to just get a little experience and get his things out of the way, but I guess that'll probably be for next time then. So it looks like I gotta do a bunch of caravan things, get whole papers, cleared up and get her to come with me. And we were really close to getting a level up too. What a shame.
Hello.
Yeah, so I'll have to head back and talk to the caravan people then. So I haven't even went into the office. I don't know if it's in Fleeside or looks like it's between them. It's either outside or inside. This ain't an evil loot though. Well, I'm actually gonna be quitting here in a little bit because I got an event I'm gonna go to. It starts at 2, so I wanna have a little time to
be waiting for it. So I just poked around here for a few minutes real quick. Ooh, excuse me.
But tonight I am going to do an extra stream. Well, I'm going to see about finishing off Boss Talk in Citizens of Space tonight. I think I got a strat and set up to be able to take him. And then I'll pretty much be done with Citizens Unite then. So, I'm on the outside. So let's... looks like it is out here then. That's the airport. It might be inside the airport thing. Was this a different building entirely actually? Because I think... the farm. Yeah, so Crimson Caravan Company. It has its own little hideaway over here just to the side. Yeah, I just need a wee little bit of experience, not even that much. They have their own little... I just expected it to be more of a little dirt hole, not a little town-ish kind of area.
If you're looking to buy or sell, you've come to the right man. The Crimson Caravan Company has the widest selection in the wasteland. Maybe. What do you want to know?
Hey there. Here's the rest of the payment I promised you back in Good Springs. I'm getting ready to run a caravan up towards Utah. There's a town called New Canaan, which is supposed to be pretty prosperous. The Crimson Caravan doesn't have any branches out that way, so it'll be up to me to get things started. Alice McLafferty runs the Crimson Caravan. You can find her over in the main office.
Hey, well, then I guess that's who I'm going to have to see then. Office? I need some caravan papers, because I got a lady I need to go to the free side with me. Probably's going to have me some dirty work I'm going to have to do, likely. Hello? So much for being in the main. Oh. Guess why? Either they didn't see you, or you just... Maybe you mixed in with that fan too much.
Welcome to the Crimson Caravan Company, New Vegas branch. What may I do for you? Certainly. I'm afraid we have no current openings for caravanners or guards, but I am in need of a runner. Deliver this invoice to Dr. Hildern. You can find him somewhere inside Camp McCarran.
So it looks like I'll have to do some. So. So I guess just ask random people if they need shit done? I guess. Anyway. It's 1:33, so I'm gonna go wind down here then. We didn't get too much progress on the main story, sadly. We got a number of side things done. Lost 2,000 caps. Got some gambling I can do off screen, so that's all cool and. So I guess he's just gonna hang out around here. You got a tad bit of your health missing there, buddy. Might wanna top that off. So I guess we'll have to look for some stuff to do around here on that.